Again, just by reaching down for our toes, nice and slow, just doing a nice warm up and then rolling up one vertebrae at a time. So keeping a slight bend to those knees, really stretching out the backs of our legs. Again, rolling up one vertebrae at a time. We'll do one more. All right, we're gonna be doing some side lunges today with the kettlebell, so I want us to warm up first. So we're gonna stretch out to the side, making sure knees aligned with that ankle, chest is lifted and proud, and then come back up. Coming back down, again, just doing a nice little warm up at first, then coming back up, making sure that that knee is not going over that toe. Good, we got one more. And then we're gonna switch on over to the other side. So whenever you're ready, again, stepping it back, knee is aligned with that ankle, chest is lifted and proud, and then coming up. So we're gonna be focusing on nice, slow, controlled tempo today with our weight, really toning and strengthening our muscles. All right, we got last one. Okay. So you can go ahead and grab, if you have that kettlebell or a dumbbell, go ahead and grab that. We're gonna do a drop squat. So with the drop squat, what we're gonna do, you're first gonna hold it at the top. If you have the kettlebell, you're holding it at the top. You're gonna squat it down, making sure those knees are staying behind those toes. You're gonna come up, lift the way that you're holding it, and then come down again. Okay, so again, holding it at the top, and then flipping it, holding it at like the bottom of that kettlebell. Let me grab a dumbbell real quick to show you how to do it with the dumbbell just in case you don't have that kettlebell. So again, you're holding it at the top, and then you're gonna flip it, holding it like that, okay? What we're gonna do is we're gonna speed it up just a tad. So I'm gonna squat it down, bring it up and down. All right, so begin when you're ready. Making sure that you're powering it through those hips, squeezing those glutes at the top. Squeezing those glutes. Good. Exhaling every time you come up, so exhale. Inhale as you go down. We got three more. Last one. Nice job. Okay, next one we're gonna do is a kettlebell swing, alternating hands. So you're gonna come down, power it up with your hips, and then bring it down, powering other side. If you have that dumbbell, you're holding the center of the dumbbell, powering it, switching arms. So let's begin whenever you're ready. Chest is lifted and proud. You're squeezing those glutes, powering it through. Good, keeping it going. I'm gonna check our music. Keep it going, alternating hands. Again, really squeezing those glutes. Good, let's do three more. And last one. Whew, good job. All right, we're gonna do a single leg deadlift with the kettlebell or the dumbbell. So one leg is gonna slowly come back. You're rolling it down and then bringing it up. All right, so you're keeping that chest lifted and proud, keeping a slight bend to that standing leg. Go ahead and begin whenever you're ready. Option for this, just reducing your range of motion, or else you can take out that weight. I want you to squeeze those glutes as you lift that leg up and try to go nice and slow. You're squaring up your hips to the side of that mat if you're using one. Good. Keeping that belly button pulled in, core is nice and tight and engaged. We got three more. Last two. Last one. Nice work. Same thing on the other side. So now the other leg is going to reach back as you roll down and then come back up. So begin when you're ready. Again, try to work nice and slow. You're flexing through that foot, squeezing those glutes as you lift that leg. Again, keeping that belly button pulled in to support that lower back. Reduce that range of motion as much as you need to. We got 5, 4, 3. Whew, if you fall out of it, just come back into it. 2, 1. Ooh, nice job. We're going to run through that circuit one more time through until we go down to our next one. So we're coming back to that drop squat. So again, you're holding top of that kettlebell or dumbbell. You're a little bit farther than hip width apart. You're going to squat it down. And then as you come up, squeeze those glutes. And then switch the handle. Squat down again. All right, so begin when you're ready. Again, squeeze those glutes. Think about powering it through those hips. All that power is coming from those hips, so that powers that weight up. Exhaling as you power it up. Good, again, all that weight is sitting back in those heels. Don't let those knees go over those toes. We got 3 more. Last 2. Last 1. Ooh, nice job. All right, we have that alternating single leg or single arm swing. So whenever you're ready, coming down, squeezing those glutes as you power that weight up. Good, begin when you're ready. I'll turn a little bit so you can see me. Again, I'm making sure all that weight is sitting back in those heels. And notice I'm powering through my hips, squeezing my glutes as I power it up. You want to make sure to keep that belly button pulled in to support that back. So exhale every time you power it up. We got 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Ooh, nice job. Back to that single leg deadlift. So, whenever you're ready, again, shoulders are down and away from those ears. Reaching one leg back as you roll down, and then come back up. Again, keeping a slight bend to that standing leg. Trying to work nice and slow. Again, squeezing those glutes, trying to get that leg up as high as you can. Keeping that chest lifted and proud. Got 3, 2, 1. Nice job. Same thing on the other side. So whenever you're ready, other leg lifts back as you roll it down and come back up. You'll notice one side has more balance than the other. That is okay. That is normal. That's why we always work both sides of the body. We got 3, 2, 1. Whew, nice job. Shake it out. All right, we're moving on to our next circuit. So this time, okay, what we're gonna do is a kettlebell swing, but with a step. So as we're swinging the dumbbell or the kettlebell out, we're gonna step, and then we're gonna squat down and step, okay? So you're gonna do it with both hands though. So you're gonna swing it out and step. Okay, so notice you don't have to step very far. And this is honestly something that's gonna take practice. It's as that dumbbell or kettlebell is going up, that's when you step. So begin when you're ready. And making sure all that weight is sitting back in those heels. squeezing those glutes the entire way up. Good. We got 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Woo, nice job. All right, kettlebell or dumbbell comes up by the shoulder. So now what we're gonna do is a side lunge. So other hand is on your hip. You're gonna lunge it to the side and then come back up, all right? Kettlebell's kind of awkward, so you need to find what way is most comfortable for you. Biggest thing, you don't wanna be bending that wrist, okay? So make sure the wrist is nice and straight. So again, you're squatting it down, knee is not behind that toe, or I mean, knee is behind that toe, and then you're coming up. So go ahead and begin when you're ready. Pause at the bottom before making it up. Working on that strength, and you're squeezing your glutes the entire way up. Use those glutes to help bring you up. So squeeze those glutes. Good. We got 4, 3, 2, 1. Whew, nice job. Switching over to the other side. Again, kettlebell or dumbbell comes up. Stepping out to the side, pausing at the bottom. All the weight is in those heels. It ain't coming up. Squeezing those glutes the entire way up. So I want you to start squeezing already down here as you bring it up. When we build that mind-body connection, research shows that the muscle gets worked even more. So that's why it's so important to really think about the muscle you're targeting to work that muscle even more. So think about that booty. We got 3, 2, 1. Whew, nice job. All right, next thing we're gonna do is bent-legged deadlift. So dumbbell or kettlebell comes right in between the legs. Feet are about hip-width apart. So what we're gonna do, you're gonna squat down. So what you're doing is I'm making sure your chest is lifted and proud, all that weight is sitting in those heels. And then you're gonna come on up nice and slow, okay? So bending it down, and then slow and controlled on your way up. I want you to think about squeezing your glutes the entire way up, activating those glutes. Again, don't let those knees go over those toes. We got 5, 4, 3, nice and slow, 2, 1, whew, nice job. All right, we're doing that circuit one more time through, starting with the swing with the step, okay? So again, as that the weight comes up, that's when you step. All right, I'll be ready. So begin. Give me there. Again, you don't have to step very far. Squeeze those glutes the entire way up. Again, all that weight is sitting back in those heels, working that booty. It also tones those inner thighs. We got 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Woo, nice job. All right, next exercise, that side lunge. We're gonna add something to it though this time, all right, if you want that extra challenge. So that weight is up above that shoulder. What we're gonna do, other hand is on that hip. We're gonna lunge down like normal, but as we come up, I want you to try to lift this knee and press this arm up. Okay, so you're gonna press it up and come back down. Again, you can always take out the lift, sticking with just that regular side lunge. Make it work for you. Make sure Your wrist is nice and neutral. Don't bend it back. Nice strong wrist. Squeeze those glutes the entire way up. We got 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Ooh, nice job. All right, other side. Again, weight is above that shoulder. Other hand is on that hip. Whenever you're ready, lunging it to the side. And then as we come up, press it up. Again, make sure that you're pausing at the bottom of this lunge and then really squeezing those glutes as you power it up. You'll notice one side is more flexible, more balanced than the other. Again, just like with everything else, that is normal. Now, often you can bring that foot down before you bring it up. That is okay. Make it work for you. We got 4, 3, 2, 1. Whew, nice job. All right. So for this final exercise in the circuit, this time we're going to do a regular deadlift. So kettlebell or dumbbell is out in front, keeping a slight bend of those knees. You're hinging at those hips just until where you feel a nice pull in the back of those legs, then squeezing your glutes the entire way up. So begin whenever you're ready. Biggest thing, make sure that you're hinging at your hips and not in that back. You want to keep your back nice and straight, chest is lifted and proud, keeping a bend of those knees the entire time. Then again, as you're down here, that's when you begin to squeeze those glutes the entire way up. So we inhale down, exhale up. We got 5, 4, keep that belly button pulled in, 3, 2, 1. Whew, nice job. All right, we're gonna come on down to the ground. Come on down, grab a quick drink if you need it. All right, then what we're gonna do is some bridge dips. So you're gonna have that weight on your lower abdomen, okay? So make sure that you have that core nice and tight and embraced, which is gonna hold that weight. So what we're gonna do, make sure those feet are nice and close to your bottom. We're gonna squeeze our glutes as we lift that weight up and then down. So go ahead and begin whenever you're ready. And all that weight is sitting back in those heels. Belly button is pulled in towards that spine. So exhale as you press it up. Inhale as you come down. Again, really focusing on the muscles you are targeting right now. Getting that mind-body connection. We got 3, 2, 1. Keep it lifted, don't bring it down. All right, you're gonna raise one leg up and then dip. We got 5, 4. Option, you can take this out into your regular bridge. 3, 2, 1. Keep it lifted, don't drop it. We're gonna take our leg out and in. We got 5, 4. Squeeze those glutes, 3, 2, 1. Whew, drop it down. Don't drop those hips. Lift your other leg up and begin. We got 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Keep it lifted. Take it out and in. 5, 4, 3. Keep that belly button pulled in. 2, 1. Whew. Keep those hips lifted. We got marching in place. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Whew. Drop it down. Catch your breath. We get this one more time through. So, catch your breath a second, and then when you're ready, regular bridge dip, let's begin. Again, you can always take this weight out if it's too much, or if you're feeling too much pressure in that lower back. You can also reduce the range of motion. So we got 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Bring it up and hold it up here. Lift that one leg up. Single leg, bridge dip, begin. Again, take that weight out whenever you need it. We got 3, 2, 1. Hold it up here. Take it out. And in. 4, 3, 2, 1. Woo. Nice job. Oh, keep those hips lifted. Oops. Lift that other leg up. Begin. Bridge dip. 4, 3, 2, 1. Keep it lifted. Take it out. And then 4, 3, 2, 1. Keep it lifted. Keep those hips lifted. Bring those legs down. What we're going to do is just marching in place. Got 9, 8, 7, 6. Knees go loose. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Woo. Nice job. Get rid of that weight for now. We're gonna flip on over to a tabletop position. So grab that quick drink if you need it. All right, so we're gonna come down onto those forearms today, okay? So head is above those hands. Those knees are still aligned underneath those hips. Belly button is pulled in. What we're gonna do, we're gonna do booty kick back. So we're not gonna kick it up like we normally do. You're gonna kick it out and then back in. All right, so kick it out, back in. Now, if you feel too much pressure on that lower back, being down in those forearms, then just come back up to those hands. Make it work for you. What this does when we're on these forearms is just work that core just a little bit more. 8, 7. Squeeze those glutes. 6, 5, 4. Again, squeeze them the entire time. 3, 2, 1, hold it, bend that knee, and then out. 8, 7, 6, keep that leg lifted. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, keep it lifted, pulse it out. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, whoo, nice. Job. Give you a bunch of surprises. All right, other side, whenever you're ready. Booty kickbacks. You're flexing through that foot. Again, keep that belly button pulled in to support that lower back. Think about squeezing those glutes the entire time. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, hold it out here, bend that knee, and then straighten it. Keep it lifted. 8, 7, 6, keep it lifted. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, keep that knee bent, and pull. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Woo. Sit it back a second. Nice child pose. Nice work. All right, let's begin to stretch it out. So I want you to kind of sit on your side, and you're just going to pull this one leg back. So what this does is stretching out our quadricep here. Big inhale through your nose, big exhale through the mouth, and then bringing this leg up, you're just going to do a little squeeze, just trying to pull it as close as you can to your body. You should feel a little pinch or a little stretch in that glute. And then we're going to come into a pigeon pose. So having that right leg straightening, trying to have the right leg paired up with the side of the mat. And then just kind of rolling over so that your hips are nice and centered with the floor. Feel that nice stretch. You can always come down onto those forearms if you like. Feel that deep stretch in the glutes, hamstrings. All right, then we're gonna come on up, then pull that other leg back. Again, just feeling a nice stretch in those quadriceps. If you need to lean back a little bit, go ahead and lean back. Stretching is so important after every workout. So anytime you have to leave early from a workout, it's so important to make sure you stretch at some point. All right, bringing that leg up, and then just kind of pulling it in nice and close to you. Nice little hug. And then leg is gonna come parallel with the side of the mat in a nice pigeon pose. And just kind of rolling over so you're nice and squared up to the floor. And again, you can stay here if you'd like, or else you can come on down to the forearms. Feel that nice stretch in those glutes. All right, let's do a nice forward fold. So bringing those feet together. Take a big inhale up and then exhale, reaching for shins, ankle, feet, wherever you can reach. Feel that nice deep stretch in the back of those legs. Now, some of these exercises we did today, they targeted deep inside that booty. This means we probably will be feeling this for a couple days, and that's okay. We want a nice toned booty for the summer, don't we? And then bring those feet in, nice butterfly. So inhale as you lift that crown of the head up towards the ceiling. And then exhale, try to fold forward a little, just opening up those hips. You can use those elbows to push down those knees. All right, nice job. I hope you guys enjoyed this kettlebell.